With so many different species of animals on Earth, you would think that there would be enough of them to keep humans happy. But still, there has always been a fascination with hybrid animals. Legends and myths are full of animal and human hybrids. Most of them would be impossible to ever exist. Still, there are some real hybrids that live on Earth today. Some have even almost become a new species on their own. Let's meet some of these strange and wonderful creatures. These are animal hybrids that actually exist. Before we get started, just a reminder to hit that like button if you enjoy the video and subscribe to our channel with the notifications turned on, and you'll stay informed with any new content that we post. First up is the liger. This hybrid is the baby of a male lion and a female tiger. They are one of the best known hybrid species and also the biggest one. They grow larger than that of a normal tiger or lion would. The biggest liger weighed a massive 16,000 pounds. They look more like a lion, but they also have light stripes that give their coats a very unique look. They're really beautiful. Their characteristics are a bit more like those of a lion than a tiger. For example, they're sociable animals who enjoy being together in groups. But some of the tiger traits also come through. They like swimming, for example, something that lions generally don't like, but tigers enjoy. You won't find these animals in nature. They are both species of cats and can breed in theory and in captivity. But in the wild, it's just a case of them not being in the same area. You can't have baby ligers when their parents never crossed paths in the first place. Interestingly enough, historically though, when there were a lot of Asiatic lions, they did cross paths with tigers. And there are many legends of ligers being born in the wild. So it is possible, just not practically probable. Next up is the Tigon. These come from male tigers with female lions. I know what you're gonna say. Aren't they the same thing? Both hybrids, a Tigon and a liger, both have one tiger and one lion parent. So wouldn't they be the exact same species? One would think so, but weirdly, that isn't how it works. The Tigon normally is way smaller than a liger would be. In fact, they don't become as big as either of their parents. They also look more like the tiger side, but they can roar and are pretty social animals too. For some strange reason, these hybrids are normally sterile. There was only one known case of a female Tigon that was able to have cubs of a male lion and where they lived to adulthood. And that was way back in 1943. Since then, no other Tigon was fertile. The Growler Bear is up next. These massive bears look pretty strange and kind of look like a giant stuffed animal. To be honest, most bears look like giant stuffed toys to me, but I know better than to try to give them a hug like you would with a giant plushie. These aren't animals to play with. And the Growler Bear is no different in that regard. They are the offspring of a grizzly bear and polar bear. There have been a few cases of these animals being born in captivity, but it seemed like something that would be unlikely to happen in the wild naturally. These species do live in the same area, but normally they would avoid each other in the wild and even show aggression towards each other. But still, there were a number of different sightings of people who saw strange looking bears, some who just didn't quite fit into the normal mold of being a grizzly or a polar bear. But it wasn't until 2006 that science could confirm that these bears do exist in the wild. A strange looking bear was shot in the Canadian Arctic, and with DNA testing, they could prove that this was in fact a Growler Bear. They are normally a little bit smaller than a polar bear and have shaggy caramel colored coats. And thanks to their grizzly genes, they are able to survive in warmer climates than a polar bear would be able to. I think these are some of the cutest hybrids that exist. Next on the list, we have the Wolfin. This is one of the rarest hybrid animals that we have on the list. They come from breeding a female bottlenose dolphin and a male false killer whale. It doesn't really make any sense to call them a Wolfin since both parents are in fact members of the dolphin family and there are no whales involved. But it was the name given to the species, and it stuck. There's at least one of these creatures alive and well, living in captivity. She was even able to have babies, and one of those lived well into adulthood. Since both these species are so closely related and occupy the same waters, it is very likely that there could be wolfin babies that are born naturally in nature. In fact, there have been a lot of sightings of these animals where people swear it was a wolfin that they spotted, but to date, scientists haven't been able to verify this beyond a doubt, so for now it remains in the category of speculation, and we don't really know for sure. What we do know is that these animals seem to be the perfect blend of their parents. They have skin that is dark gray, a mix between the light gray of the bottlenose and the black skin of the false killer whale. The bottlenose dolphin has 88 teeth and the false killer whale has 44 teeth. Their baby, the wolfin, has the average between the two, 66. It's pretty strange that nature can balance out so perfectly, isn't it? The jaguar lion is up next. To date, there are only two jaglions that are known, and they were the result of true love between a male jaguar and a female lion. The lion and the jaguar both went to Bear Creek Wild Sanctuary within a short time of each other and grew up in the same nursery where they were bottle fed. They soon became each other's closest companions. When they grew up, attempts were made to separate them, but things didn't go well. Both would get severely depressed and super anxious, and Lola the lion even refused to eat. It was becoming a safety hazard. So after multiple attempts, the sanctuary made peace with the fact that Lola and Diablo would stay together. So from then on, they would separate Lola each time she came into Estrus to make sure that they didn't have any unexpected guests. But I guess no form of birth control is 100% safe. And to their surprise, Lola gave birth to two little healthy jaglion cubs. One with the coloring of a lion, but with the rosette pattern of a jaguar. The other with a stunning dark gray coat with black spots. I guess love finds a way. They did eventually separate Diablo and Lola, but they still share a fence and are able to communicate. They just can't engage in any more baby-making activities. The Emerald Green Alicia has to be on this list. This is not just the weirdest hybrid on this, but also one of the weirdest animals I've ever heard of. Or should that be the weirdest plant? This is a hybrid between a sea slug and LJ. The sea slug takes genetic material and eats it, and it goes into its own DNA. Somehow this results in a plant and animal hybrid. It can consume food like a normal animal, but it also has plant-like leaves that helps it absorb nutrients through photosynthesis. It is like this slug has its own solar power built in. The ability they have to use solar energy for food is what gives them their vivid and stunning green color. Scientists have said that a lot more research is needed to figure out how this phenomenon happens, which I think is called for. They have no clue what is happening there, but this is pretty cool nonetheless. Wow. Up next is the Camma. These hybrid animals come from a male camel and a female llama. They were intentionally created to produce an animal that is docile as a llama but as strong as a camel. They also produce way more of the soft, fluffy wool than their mothers would be able to give, so they are way more economical than their parents. It is impossible for these animals to naturally occur since male llamas and female camels don't seem to be fruitful when paired. And it would be very dangerous to naturally pair a male camel with a female llama since the camel is 6 times heavier than a llama. So it is pretty easy to see that she would just get hurt. So the only way to accomplish this pairing was to use artificial insemination, and through this method, the first camel was born on the 14th of January 1998. Then we have the Savannah Cat. These massive cats are said to be the perfect balance for dog and cat lovers. They come from pairing a domestic cat and a serval, an African wildcat. They are said to be great pets. They are much larger than a normal house cat and can be trained to walk on a leash. And they're also said to have the loyalty that would compare to that of a dog. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about having a kitten that is once removed from a wild cat living in my house. Cats by themselves can be pretty wild. But one thing is certain, these are really stunning animals. A wolf dog is another pet hybrid. Dogs come from wolves anyway. But when one of their parents or grandparents in the last 5 generations were a full-blood wolf, they are still called a wolf dog. There are even some established wolf dog breeds. These animals are stunning but are said to be pretty unpredictable. They might look like a normal dog or very much like a wolf. They could completely act like a dog, or the wild wolf side could come out and you could have a problem. There are many other hybrid animals in the world, some occurring naturally and others only with the intervention of humans. They are interesting to see and to experience. Until the next time, we'll catch you later.